everyone! Today, we got the most amount of weapons to talk about outside of the lower tiers, because we're talking about the mid-tiers and high tiers. We got a lot of weapons here with potential to go higher or potential to go lower. This is always the most controversial part of tier lists, so we're going to cover them again. Splat zones only, no order in the tiers, for competitive play. Let's get started. So, I think junior and bubble use in general has kind of dropped off a little bit. In fact, I'll even talk about mini at the same time here. There was a little bit of hype for bubble weapons when Zuka was being overused, but now that that transitioned a bit more to crab and stuff, I think that mini and junior just lost a bit of their niche to be here. And I think, honestly, with that in place, I can't really say they're much higher. I think mini still does have mist, which isn't great for it, and junior still has low fighting capabilities. I'm going to put Neo Splash here, and I'm going to rank T-Tech and A. We're going to go a little bit out of order to talk about these two because they are so, so similar. I think T-Tech is a little bit better if you're going to pick strikes. One, it is 20 points cheaper. Two, I think Splat Bomb's a bit better. And three, I think that Neo Splash plays a bit too much for spamming strike, and T-Tech can be a bit more flexible. And I think right now, that flexibility is a little bit better. And so I think T-Tech is a little bit higher. I think Neo Splash is really only for insane strike maps. And even then, I think the more time goes on, the more we're seeing T-Tech played over it. Forge Pro, like with the Forge buffs I talked about last time, has gotten a little bit better. It still doesn't get a whole lot of Booyah Bomb. It still doesn't have great stats, but it's a little bit better. I could see it winning something. But I don't know, at the same time, I'm not seeing a whole lot of it, so maybe it will move down in the future, or maybe Pro will get another buff. Custom Jet is basically your Inkstorm spamming weapon of this meta. If you really want something that'll like paint at mid-range, apply chip, and get rain, this is here. But I don't know, all the pieces of this kit are just kind of whatever. Everything has the same please move without really forcing anything to happen. So I think compared to some of the other backlines, there's just not anything as extremely powerful here as other weapons have. I think Ballpoint Nuvo goes here as well. I think V-Jet is a bit better for the VAC niche, so I guess again here, we'll talk about both weapons simultaneously. I think the idea of this weapon is to have VAC ready a lot and be able to use it as both a tool to swing a fight in your favor, but most importantly as a regroup option. Both these weapons are responsible for giving jumps, and I think V-Jet is going to have VAC more often, is going to move and sustain paint a little bit more frequently, and therefore will work a little bit better. I still have my doubts about V-Jet, we haven't seen it as much recently, but I think with the insane amount of paint plus 180p, it is a little bit better at doing this unique niche, which has been proven to work in similar metas, and therefore I think still can now. I would put Vanilla Charger here as well. This is another VAC option, but in this case you're picking it more for the charger. I think that Firefin is a better kit 9 times out of 10. But if you want Charger and it's a really good vacuum option, I think it's totally okay. Next up, I debated this, but I'm actually going to put both heavies in B tier. I think the kits on these are just kind of whatever. The main is still, like, very solid. It's pretty good at fighting a lot of different weapons, and so I think it's okay. But at the same time, I just don't really see a lot of these weapons. I don't think the kits are anything special anymore. And so while they definitely seem solid, I just don't really think there's that much of a reason to see them in competitive play as much these days, and their usage rate has kind of dropped. I'll talk about both VDS and CDS at the exact same time here. I think that Custom Dually Scorcher has a bit better kit. I think the beacons on it work fine, and while a bomb is a little bit better, I think the special is solidly in Super Chump's favor. It's a very fast ink tank refill, which can be useful for it. It puts paint out on the objective. It's something that it can use as a distraction while it dives. And I think the Dually Sculpture does play a lot better in zones than the other modes. It's pretty good at taking attention. It is just a little bit weak. It still just doesn't do a whole lot of damage. It can struggle to get its kills without help. And so I think that's what keeps it from being much higher right now. Next up would be both Tetra Dualies. I think that these are about the same. It's really just, do you want to have a sub-weapon, or do you want to have a special weapon? I think you pick the Slider Tetra mostly for the Slider Cheese maps, and you pick the light ones for everything else, but I'm not a Tetra player by any means. These weapons have struggled a bit recently because their kits are kind of whatever, and in a fighting-based meta where Cooler has made everything faster, Tetra doesn't really have as unique a niche of just doing QR things as it used to. I think this weapon really does need a third fully synergistic kit. It sucks that the Zipcaster kit got Sprinkler, but that's where I put it. I'm gonna put Cerebrella down here as well. Yep, even in its best mode, I think it's just a B-tier weapon. Like, the kit is amazing. It really is. But you do not get a lot of ink jets, and outside of that, you just have a main weapon that I think has been really struggling. I've been seeing more and more good Brella players switch to more just charge up and special power up builds and try to inkjet spam, and it just feels like the trend of Nova all over again, and I just don't see it lasting. I think the main weapon just has to be a bit better at fighting for this kit to work. I don't really think they should go the route of making it an inkjet spammer, but if they aren't going to make the main weapon better, I do think you need to get more of the specials. I'm actually going to put both Vanilla and Custom Blaster in the same tier. I do think that Vanilla Blaster is a little bit better, but honestly, Custom Blaster has a lot of arguments to be used. Splashdown gives it a bit more aggressive power, Point Sensor can allow it to do things like Gambit or work more against stealthy comps, Splashdown does provide a little bit more paint output, which especially on zones if you can use it on it, which is arguably a bit more useful, and you know, Splashdown is okay all things considered with good synergy for the main weapon. I think this weapon does still struggle a bit more on zones compared to the other modes. I think that this is a weapon that really thrives on something more like Tower. It does struggle to influence the objective, and compared to Range or Rapids, it doesn't really have as much influence at a longer distance to make up for it, but are still fairly solid slayers that in the right comp can definitely work. I'm actually going to rank all three brushes here. I think Octobrushes lean a bit more to killing than to the distraction that Inkbrush does, but I think all of these are very similar in terms of their spot. All of them have pretty solid kits that work for what they want to do, but none of the kits are really insane at anything. All of them have problems fighting certain comps depending on the range, and all of them struggle to do anything super distraction heavy with, again, cooler and a lot of speed. But still, they are solid enough main weapons. Inkbrush leans a bit more to paint and distracting, and Octobrushes lean a bit more to sharking and killing. So I think they're all in an okay spot right now, and a little bit of buffs to the weapons or kits could make them a little bit higher. I think Reflux goes in B. We have been seeing a little bit more results outside of Turf War here, and so I do think it can be placed a little bit higher. Reflux players have gotten a bit better at it, and on top of that, the buffs to it have made it more consistent. However, I don't think it's enough to put it higher. It still hasn't really won anything outside of Turf War. It does still struggle with its fighting consistency, and it does still have a bit of a range issue. Now that we know it's not going to get a better kit, at least for a while, I hope we see a little bit more buffs to this thing. A little bit more range on the full charge, and I think we could see it taking tournaments. It's a very unique weapon. Finally, the last missile weapon I haven't ranked, the Wiper Deco, will also go into this tier. I think that this weapon is okay, mainly because it is still a wiper, which is very fast with decent painting capabilities, and missiles are still missiles, but you're not going to get a lot of them, and this weapon does have a very slow kill time outside of its up-close range one-shot, and Beacon really just doesn't work as well for that. Even if the vanilla wiper kit seems a little bit weaker on paper, I think the synergy it has with the weapon and its role makes it better than this one. Alright, on to the more higher tier weapons. Let's talk about both of the Gals. I think that both of these are very interesting wall slayers. Wall is very useful depending on the matchups and comps you're fighting against, especially if it's low amounts of bombs, and so I think they have their utility there. Both of these struggle on lockout a bit. 52 definitely a bit more than 96. I think 52 has to rely on just sharking pretty much to try to find a kill and is a lot more predictable, where 96 is more actual range to pressure people. Both of these have okay specials. I think that Kraken still works fine depending on the comp you're fighting. It's good for targeting some of the other specials like Crab. Whereas Whale on 52, which seems a lot better, has pretty much no synergy with 52 itself. The amount of Whale that needs to hit to shave a shot to kill is just a bit too much for me to really see it as something that works amazing with it and is more for the other weapon. So both of these are solid options that I think struggle depending on what they're fighting and are really good against others. I would say 96 is probably a little bit better, but they are very comparable. Carbon Roller Deco goes here. It is still closer to niche than anything. We have been seeing Carbon Roller drop off a little bit recently, especially compared to Vanilla Roller, which I'll have to talk about later because it's actually not in this tier. However, of course, still has an insane kit, still has a pretty good special, still can work fine with cooler since you can choose when you pick it up and have times to go in, so you're getting a bit more Zooka output even if you can't shark as much, and burst bombs give it something to do when it's locked out. So all in all, a solid option that, depending on the map, could be very, very useful. Machine Neo would go here as well. I think this kit is a bit better in some of the other modes, but in zones, it's still very nice if you want point sensor and a more aggressive machine as opposed to the vanilla, even if the kit is a little bit weaker and not as good for the objective. So that's kind of where I would put it right now. It gets decent special output. It's still a pretty solid main weapon, all things considered. It's okay at fighting. It's still very fast, especially with cooler strafe speed in terms of its movement. It doesn't honestly feel that slow in terms of strafing speed. Of course, in terms of actual end lag into squid form, yeah, that's pretty bad. But I think it has the range and area of effect to make up for it and is pretty solid in that regard. Let's start with Bamboo. Bamboo is probably a bit of personal bias, but I think this is a very solid main weapon with a very solid kit. It has good synergy, it's easy to use the autobomb, it can locate people, the whale is something it can combo off of. There are some maps it struggles with, it can be a bit awkward with comps sometimes, but like, you know, I feel like it's still pretty solid. It is still Bamboo. It doesn't really have anything super bad about it by any means, and I could really just see it working with a really good Bamboo player. Though again, to be fair, this does feel a bit more personal bias, and if I were ranking purely based off results, this would probably be a tier lower. But hey, I'ma give it another little cycle, see if someone can make it work. And yeah, Ollie has a point. There's a bit more splashdown in the game, so I guess that's technically a buff. I'm not going to talk about E-Leader very much, because I think E-Leader is something you pick for the really long-range maps you don't want ZF on, which is becoming increasingly little. You have Wavebreaker, which just really isn't that great. So while Zekofin's kit isn't perfect, it tends to be a little bit better and is generally the weapon that Chargers are picked for. And so in terms of what Chargers are picked for now, I will talk about that when we get to ZF later in the next episode. Pencil B also comes here. I really don't know how many comps we're going to be seeing it, because even with its ability to be picked alongside another cooler option, double cooler is a thing you can also do. And I feel like wall on it isn't as useful as it is on something like Zekofin, and again, rain is just okay. It's still very nice for some of the zone cheese maps that you would normally run pencil on. It's still a pencil, which is still very good, so of course, it's fine. I just don't think we're going to see it a lot compared to the vanilla pencil. I would put Nautilus here, actually. Nautilus on paper seems like it has the potential to be higher. It's a good point sensor niche, rain is fine on it, and shaves off a shot to kill, and it is an incredibly strong Slayer weapon. However, I think the main problem is the amount of mid-range weapons that can actually deal with it in higher tiers, which is, again, something we'll have to talk about when we get to top tiers, but when I get to that section, just keep in mind the amount of weapons that have long-range area of effect that have the ability to actually outrange it or be matchups that could be a bit of a problem for it. And again, as solid as Nautilus's kit is, it is not amazing by any means. It could be a lot better, and so I think it just barely misses out on the top tiers. It could be a bit higher, but I think the counterplay keeps it down here for now, and it doesn't have enough results for me to put it higher. Ballpoint Swaddling, I think, goes here. Ballpoint is actually dropping off a bit. I think it's just struggling against more and more matchups. Again, Pencil is just very common. We're seeing more of Squeezer, which is good into it as well. I think there's more comps that you can pick against it. And also, I think its jetpack output is actually not quite as good as it used to. It might even be a little bit of a problem for the weapon. Not that big a deal. It is still a ballpoint. It's a very flexible and very solid weapon with one of the best kits in the game. Far from bad by any means. But like with Nautilus, we are seeing more and more matchups that are making it difficult to play ballpoint into, and that has resulted in it dropping off a bit. I'm gonna put S-Blast 91 here. We haven't seen too much of the weapon yet. It is something you need to dedicate to, but I think it's more than fair to say that the kit it has is very strong. Obviously, it is still Burst Bomb and Booyah Bomb, and even if you don't get a ton of Booyah Bomb, that is an insane kit, especially on a blaster. The weapon is still a little bit slow in terms of close range, so it is very easy to be able to trade out or win a fight with it, but its hitbox is also still useful at securing damage on people, and its long range mode is incredibly fast with solid combos for its burst bomb, and is still a threatening thing you need to keep in mind when playing against it in the open. It does still have small area of effect compared to range, so it doesn't have quite the pressure of that weapon, but I think the kit makes up for it a little bit, especially given that it does have burst combos. Burst combos are a little bit weaker in terms of bomb defense being good against it, but right now that's not that common, and I think even then, the burst bomb's ability to help its mobility and poking in general still make it an insanely strong kit. Long Rapid I'm gonna put here. I think its kit helps it kill a little bit better, but it's still not that strong a package. I think Whale for it is pretty amazing. It is really useful in terms of the synergy it has with the weapon, in terms of being very easy to combo off the damage with both directs and indirects. However, even as the best weapon dart-wise synergy, by a landslide, Dart is still Dart. It is still nowhere near as good as something like Rapid Deco's Torpedo, and I do think it holds it back a little bit. Obviously, it has a paint issue, but Rapid Prodeco and Rapid Deco are both very good into so many of the mid-range matchups that we'll be seeing as we get higher up the list. I'm a little bit of an end parry believer. I'm gonna be honest, this weapon could be a tier below, but I do think this is basically a slightly better Tetra. That's kind of how I see this weapon. It's a bit better of a main weapon, with a bit more flexibility, with a special that has a lot more utility, and again, due to the main weapon of end parry, I think it is a little bit better at getting splashdowns in spots where it's going to get solid value. I could be wrong, this weapon is still new, I could see it going down a bit lower if the kit doesn't turn out, and of course, I think most of the time the vanilla dually kit is better, but I could still see this one doing things. I think a really aggressive and mechanically skilled dually player can make a lot happen with this weapon. Vanilla Wiper, like with End Parry, this is a kind of Tetra playstyle that I believe in a little bit more. I think it's a bit more flexible since it adds the up-close one-shot. I think its kit is a lot better since it has good synergy and dealing with things like Torpedo could be a bit of a problem with it. I think depending on the matchup or situation, Stamp can get decent value with it. Of course, it does still struggle with killing as a whole. It does still have Stamp, which is a bit mediocre, but I could see this weapon doing well. It does still have enough utility to where I think it is very valuable to run depending on the comp and player. Honestly, I think the A tier weapons are in a pretty good spot as a whole. I think that most of the mid tiers are probably going a bit more lower than higher, but I can see some of them improving. And if balance patches get a bit better with their buffs, I think that these are going to be in a solid spot. I don't see many of these going down too much lower, so we'll have to see what happens. But of course, we got one more set of tiers to talk about, the top tiers, which we'll get to next episode. Thanks so much for watching. Have a good one.